In this video, we'll look into hanging punctuation property in CSS. We'll explore what it is, how to use it, we'll look into browser support and figure out if it's a good idea to use it today, and I'll also share a few gotchas that you should keep in mind before using it in production. Hanging punctuation is a neat CSS property that lets you specify whether you want punctuation marks like quotes, brackets, comma, or period to hang at the start or at the end of the line of text. And here's a good example of that. We have a quote that's often attributed to Albert Einstein, and we have a quote mark at the start and at the end of the line. Now, if I want to hang the opening quotation mark outside of the line of text, all I have to do is type in hanging punctuation and type in first. And if I save it, you'll see that we have the quotation mark hanging outside. This doesn't look really nice because the last word here wraps to the second line. I carefully picked this quote, so if we hang the quote outside, it will actually fit nicely. So let's add that to our CSS. So if I add last, we'll see that the entire quote fits nicely and the only thing that hang outside is the quotation mark. This works not just with quotation mark like we can see in this example, but also with parentheses, angle brackets, and other punctuation marks. So here I have the exact same quote wrapped in parentheses and you can see that they also hang outside of the container. The only thing you should keep in mind as well is that in order for comma and period to hang at the end of the line, you need to add another value to hanging punctuation property called allow and. And that's only for comma and period to hang at the end of the line. This property cascades, so you don't actually have to add it to every single selector for them to use hanging punctuation. You can define it globally on the HTML. So if I uncomment this, we'll have the exact same effect. There are a few gotchas with this. The first one is that if there's not enough space for punctuation marks to hang, it can cause horizontal scrolling. Let me show you how it happens. This is how the site looks on a small screen, and you can see that we have our hanging punctuation sitting in the spot where the site gutter is, the space that prevents the content to touch the edges of the screen. But if I disable that space, you'll notice that right now we don't have horizontal scrolling. And if I disable that space, we'll actually have the horizontal scrolling. So I have a variable called measure default that controls the width of the container. So if I override it here, let's say I set it to 100% and use important to make it like sure, we'll disable that space. And if I try to scroll the page, oh, look at that. It scrolls now, which is like not the desirable behavior. I understand that this is an edge case, but it's something that you should keep in mind when using this feature. To prove that it's that feature, not something else, if I disable hanging punctuation, you'll see that scrolling disappears and it now works perfectly fine. And there's one more gotcha you should keep in mind before using this feature in production, and that is working with inputs. Like in this example, here I have a newsletter form that's work in progress. It's not looking good right now, but it will help us illustrate the example. So what if I wanted to type in my name like this, Dima, aka Dimitri, because that's the short version of my name. So, and I want to put it in quotes. So like if I copy it from here and put it into this input, remember that we have hanging punctuation first, last, and allow and enabled globally for every single element. So if I paste it in, you'll see that we don't actually have the first quotation mark, and that's because it's clipped inside the input. It's sort of like it hangs outside, but because it's an input, you don't see it. That's not ideal behavior. You should probably not do it for inputs. So that's why if I use it, I would probably not enable it globally and be more tactical about where I want this feature to be enabled. And what about browser support? Well, it's not great. It's only working in Safari as of today. And it's been like that since 2016, which is pretty weird. They've added support for hanging punctuation in 2016 and no browsers have added support for it yet. But anyways, does it mean that we cannot use it in prod today? I don't think so, because this feature is an enhancement. It's not something fundamental. If it doesn't work, the worst thing that can happen is your quotes will, some of them will wrap to the next line, which is not a big deal because they're still accessible. You can still read the information. You're not missing out on anything. It's just a slight difference in visual appearance. Unlike features like layers, even though it has wide support, but I would still not use it in production today. I have a video just about that. So if you're curious, give it a watch. Like and subscribe if you like this video, and I'll see you in the next one.